Thank you so much for the interesting session, Jayesh, and thank you E4M for giving me the opportunity. I'm going to talk about the role of OOH in the brand strategy or client's media strategy. Yeah, and hopefully I'll be able to keep the momentum on and the positivity around OOH on through my presentation. So this is an iconic location which Coke has used over 60 years, and you've seen the role or the evolution of OOH media over 60 years. The look and feel has changed, the location has remained same, the brand has remained same, and it's become like a, you know, the name for the location itself, but overall experience for the consumer has evolved over a period of time. I'm going to repeat the same slide as Jayesh, sorry for this, but the good thing in this slide is that it has bounced back, and we are going to be much higher, as Jayesh mentioned, as we move forward. So that's a good news for us. Now, there are multiple roles that the brand look for or in the media strategy when OOH is being considered. As an omni-channel strategy, location targeting, this is a very big positive that the media offers to us, that we can specifically target our audiences in the restricted geography and highlight our you know, messaging or the communication to our TG, reiterate that, and there is no skippable option in this medium. So people have to see the communication, the messaging for the brand. Attention grabbing, you can do a lot of innovative things, and I was really happy to see the holographic evolution or the innovation that Jayesh was talking about. So attention grabbing, so this media offers a lot of innovation ideas for the brands to bring that bring their brand closer to the audiences, create that kind of engagement with the consumers, which typically other mediums like television, etc., may not be able to create that. Brand building brand association, so if you want to drive a brand message in an innovative, interactive manner, this is one of the medium that you can use. Call to action, he did speak about the QR codes or the website URLs that you can include in the out-of-home medium and which people can, you know, scan and go to their websites. So this is another use that, you know, the brands would look for. Reach multiplier, for sure. So I will have case studies actually supporting each of these roles. Given the time that we have after lunch, so I don't want to speak too much, but support all of these roles through different case studies and highlight the use of OOH more in terms of the brand strategies or the media strategies. So omni-channel strategy, all brands would want to be you know, participating in the connected world because that's the future. Our consumers are in the connected ecosystem. And today, technology provides us that facility to synchronize our messages across digital, offline, and we've seen some examples in the previous presentation. There is a case study that I'm going to show after this, which is Nexa Balino. They have beautifully integrated or leveraged the power of OOH and have highlighted the features of the car depending on the time of the day, the location nuances, and the traffic at the location. So I'm just playing this. Hopefully you'll be able to see, hear the audio as well. No audio?
Yes. So Puneet, I said that I'm going to take your case study to talk about it. Sorry for this, but yeah, that was a case study from Lemma. So location targeting, again, is another advantage that we bring in here through OOH as a medium. And if we can serve the communication at the right place, at the right time, to the right audiences, that becomes very powerful. So in this example by DKNY, they actually created the niche audiences using a platform, overlaid the digital inventory to reach the right target audiences, and they used 15 different creatives which were used at different point in time to reach out or engage with the right TG, and it was quite successful. So that is an advantage which digital medium actually, digital OOH actually offers to you, so you can have multiple creatives reaching out to your consumers through that single asset. This is another example where KFC utilized it quite effectively using smoking billboards. And here they could, one is attention grabbing. So it was attention grabbing because the whole billboard was emitting smoke during the peak hours. But it could drive the key message that the brand was trying to drive in through to the consumers, which is great taste. So brand could build the association with that great taste. Now, if the billboard can actually solve a real life problem, nothing could be more engaging than that. So in this example, how the brand used OOH or a billboard to help solve the critical problem that the people were facing.
UTEC, the University of Engineering and Technology, was about to open the application period for 2013, so they needed to call students' attention. Lima and its surrounding villages are located in the coastal desert of Peru. In this place, there are many people suffering from the lack of potable water. The presence of rain in this region is almost zero, but the atmospheric humidity is about 98%. Inspired by this, we worked as a team, UTEC and the agency, to build the first billboard that produces drinking water out of air. The billboard has a unique technology that captures the air humidity and turns it into drinking water.
Cada generador atrapa lo que es la humedad del ambiente. De ahí pasa un sistema de osmosis inversa. Cada tanque almacena por medio de 20 litros. Las cinco máquinas van a hacer este proceso y se va a almacenar todo en un solo tanque.
The billboard has already produced thousands of liters of drinking water. That equals the water consumption of hundreds of families per month.
¿No? Que pongan en diferentes lugares, ¿no? Que es posible en cada anexo, en cada caserío, en cada pueblo, para que el agua sea generada por medio de los paneles, ¿no? Un agua que realmente nos da vida, ¿no?
UTEC, the University of Engineering.
Sorry. Yeah, so this is the example which might look a little distant from the brand messages typically, but you have a lot of these purpose-led messaging that the brands want to communicate these days, so this is a good example for that. Now, driving brand message again through OOH, there was a similar example that Jayesh talked about. So this is a quick video on a similar one from a different market. So the brand messages can come alive through a very engaging manner if you use innovation in your OOH as a medium. again, bridging the gap between the digital and the physical worlds. So in this example, the digital storefronts were brought to the street. All the deals which were on digital platform were communicated through this OOH as a medium across multiple assets, which was kiosks, bus shelters, and et cetera. QR codes were given so people could scan the QR code and land on the website, see the entire portfolio which is being offered, and also buy the product on the website. So this also offers measurement to the digital, to the OOH as a medium, because you can then figure out how many people have seen it, scan it, and you know, landed on the website. This, I'm sure all of you are familiar with this case study, which is from British Airways, which won the Cannes Award. This is again to build engagement and interaction with the consumers, their audiences. Sorry.
What the public saw as magic was actually a carefully orchestrated feat of technology. We mounted an ADS-B antenna on the roof of a nearby building to read live data directly from each aircraft's transponder within 200 kilometers. All aircraft emit radio waves containing their speed, altitude, GPS location, and a call sign. Our antenna was connected to a PC with a custom-built application, which identified the British Airways planes and sent the data to our cloud server that controlled the billboards. We created a virtual trigger zone in the sky that acted like a tripwire, so that when a BA plane entered our trigger zone, within 0.2 seconds we'd cross-reference the registration number with flight data from Heathrow to determine the destination. Cloud altitude data told us if the plane could be seen, and if it could, the information was sent to our billboard, interrupting the current content and playing our ad. We targeted a moment. The moment a plane flies overhead, inspiring our audience to share what they saw and igniting their passion to explore the world.
This is another attention-grabbing communication. You would have noticed it on LinkedIn. It was becoming very popular in the recent times. It is, again, the right place, the right time, and the message delivered in a very innovative way. Very tempting. Sorry, it again replays. So this is another ad which is very popular. It creates a lot of engagement. It happened in Japan, in outside the station for Nike.
Thank you.
Now, OH is a reach multiplier. This was beautifully used by Tesco Home Plus a couple of years back in South Korea, where they wanted new users to come in and shop at Tesco.
Tesco Home Plus is number two in Korea. Tesco had to overcome one obstacle, a fewer number of stores compared to the number one company. Mission: could we become number one without increasing the number of stores? Idea: let the store come to people. We created virtual stores. Our first try was subway stations. Although virtual, the displays were exactly the same as actual stores. Only one thing is different. You use smartphones to shop. Scan the QR code with your phone and the product automatically lands in your online cart. When the online purchase is done, it will be delivered to your door right after you get home. Result: people can shop at Tesco Home Plus wherever they go without having to visit the actual store. Currently, Home Plus has become number one in the online market and is a very close second offline.
So mobile out of home is the best solution for reach multiplier. You can make the entire set of consumers en route about your brand, the message that you want to communicate. And today, you have beautiful bus wraps and train wraps available for your brands. Then call to action, so which was beautifully used by Calvin Klein. They used this entire billboard with the QR code, and people could scan it and download the content that they are interested in, and also can post it on social media. So billboards, you can use QR codes, promo codes, multiple other options, and create engagement on social media platforms using this medium. How luxury brands are using out-of-home, we all of us know, and I'm sure you would have seen this ad again, Jack Ma's bags, you know, moving in Paris on the street. So this creates not only just the awareness, but also the buzz around it, not only in their country or in their city, across the nation, across the world. Then you have, why is it not moving? Yeah, Emporio Armani, Michael Kors, all, you can have it in the high street areas where your target audience is, so very, very specific targeting for your audiences. And then you have these luxury pillars which are used by high-end brands. Now, OH can do wonders to the brand in their entire strategy. So that, I'm sure I've been able to convince you, and you know it best because we have experts in this area sitting in the room. But measurement is also important. And if you use OH in combination with other media vehicles, then it becomes even more powerful. So in this case, very specifically, it was used by Danone, one of their brands, where they were the objective was to acquire new users or new buyers. And they launched a multimedia campaign across OH, Facebook, and television. And the combined effect of digital and OH was much higher than expected. So it's 13% higher than higher purchase intention than what was expected. So obviously, as combination, as an overall media strategy, OH plays a very vital role in the overall strategy for brands. And impact of measurement, and I heard that there are a lot of new ways to measure the impact of OH on its own. And 66% of the smartphone users took online action after seeing something on OH, or seeing an ad on OH, as per the Nielsen report. And we keep debating, you know, in our entire media mix, ROI, how do we measure the impact of out of home? And the best is to see the impact on sales. So there are different techniques that we can use to look at multimedia impact on sales, but there are other methods, and I'm sure all of you are expert in looking at these options to drive more ROI for your clients. So there are various methods that we've listed out here. So far, yeah, hopefully all these case studies were able to support the role of out-of-home media is very big in the entire media strategy of the clients. Now, this is not a paints ad, by the way. It's an ad for the insurance company. Thank you so much.